Major expressways, transportation agencies, and terminals in Metro Manila bracing for the influx of passengers ahead of the Holy Week break. Andrea Taguines gives us a look.
The North Luzon Expressway Corporation now on full alert as the Holy Week exodus begins. According to NLEX, from a daily average volume of 300,000 vehicles, they expect that number to go up further by 10% this Holy Week. That's why as early as Friday, they've already opened all lanes and suspended all roadworks. Management hopes their recent road widening projects and the additional exits they will put in place can help alleviate the heavy traffic in some areas.
Yung sa may Kawayan area kung saan madalas or halos araw-araw po tayo nakakaranas po ng matinding traffic po doon sa area. No? So last year, unimpasar na po namin yung widening po nung pa-exit ng may Kawayan northbound. Yung spur from SETEX to NLEX, yung tinatawag naming B3 ramp, kung saan pagka ganitong dagsaan ay laging may pila doon, ma-open na po ito ngayong Sunday, itong Palm Sunday. So ini-inspect na lang po yon, ni-rush po talaga yon in time na matapos po ngayong Holy Week season.
Passengers have also started flocking to the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange or PITX. Even though April Sarsoza wasn't able to book a ticket in advance, he said he had no trouble buying one. He is headed to his hometown of Surigao del Sur for the wake of his sister.
Kasi palagi akong pinaparamdam niya, napapauwiin sa tuwing natutulog ako. Bago daw siya ilibing na uuwi daw ako, uuwiin ko muna daw siya.
According to PITX, the expected surge in travelers will be on Holy Wednesday and the morning of Maundy Thursday. It expects more than 1.7 million travelers to pass through the terminal throughout the week. To make sure there are enough buses to accommodate passengers, the Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board has already issued over 1,000 special permits.
Ang mga nag-file po simula ng February 26 to March 8, ang duration po ng special permit ay March 24 hanggang March 31 po, no? At meron din pong March 22 up to April 14.
The good thing is, during the Holy Week, they will assign LTFRB personnel right there at PITX to issue special permits as needed.
The PITX is also coordinating with traffic authorities for a quicker turnaround time of buses.
Sa pagpupulong natin with DOTR, specifically minensyon natin to, tsaka sa mga LGU na dadaanan going towards the provinces, na baka pwede, no, tulungan tayo sa pagmaman ng trapiko upang sa ganun, mas mapabilis at di mabarang yung mga pampublikong sasakyan going out and in of Metro Manila.
Meanwhile, the Philippine Coast Guard will deploy 20,000 personnel in ports nationwide as it goes on heightened alert Saturday.
Ayaw na nating maulit yung mga nagkakaroon ng aksidente dahil sa overloading. May instruction si Admiral Gaban, ang komandant ng Philippine Coast Guard, sa lahat ng mga station commanders. Dapat makita nila yung mga barko o yung mga sakyan dagat bago umalis. Huwag na huwag na hindi titingnan. At kung meron, pababain, huwag paalisin. At kung talagang mapilit, i-detain yung mga bangka.
The Philippine Ports Authority expects over 2 million passengers to travel by sea this Holy Week. PPA General Manager Jay Santiago inspected the Batangas port earlier this week and touted the increased seating capacity of the terminal there from 2,500 to 8,000. Meanwhile, over 1 million passengers are expected to fly out next week from the Philippines' main gateway, the Ninoy Aquino International Airport.
Ang mga key officials po ng ating paliparan ay pinagbawalan na po mag-leave. We cannot go on vacation during this period because we will be manning itong mga offline help desks natin. No? So definitely per terminal, meron po tayong key official ng MIA na tatao dito.
Airport authorities are already coordinating with the Bureau of Immigration and the Bureau of Customs to address long lines at their stations. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Health Department declares a code white alert from March 24 until March 31. This is part of the agency's preparations for possible health emergencies during the Holy Week exodus. Code white is declared during national events and holidays that can potentially cause mass casualty incidents or emergencies. During this, medical personnel and staff are placed on standby for immediate response. A city in the Visayas region set to declare an outbreak of pertussis or whooping cough a day after one of Metro Manila's biggest cities made a similar announcement. More from Johnson Manabat.
Over 400 pertussis cases have been lodged by the Philippine Department of Health throughout the country as of March 9th. 35 of those cases resulted in deaths. The DOH has noted cases in at least four regions. Pasig City's Public Information Office says 16 of the suspected cases were confirmed to be pertussis, with majority among infants less than 2 months old who have not completed or begun vaccination. Quezon City on Thursday declared a pertussis outbreak. One city in the Visayas is also set to do the same.
Pinakamarami dito sa Metro Manila, tapos sa Calabar Zone, at saka dyan po sa Region 7, Central Visayas. Kagabi, natitinto po pagdideklara ng outbreak dyan sa Iloilo City. May isang po kaya ta silang kaso.
But the Department of Health clarified that pertussis or whooping cough disease is nothing new in the Philippines, with vaccines already available.
Ang pertussis ay hindi bagong sakit. Matagal nang nandiyan yan at matagal na rin may bakuna. Dahil lamang sa ating pandemic worldwide, hindi tayo nakapagbakuna, not only in the Philippines but in many other places. Kaya ngayon, 4 years since the pandemic. So ngayon lumalabas yung mga dating bata na sanggol na pinanganak ng pandemic. Malamang sa malamang sila ngayon yung mga nakikitaan nito, and many other vaccine-preventable diseases.
According to the World Health Organization, pertussis, also known as whooping cough, is a highly contagious respiratory infection which can spread easily from person to person, mainly through droplets produced by coughing or sneezing. Domingo said, the disease is most dangerous in infants and is a significant cause of disease and death in this age group.
Yung pertussis ay dahil sa bacteria, yung Bordetella pertussis. Nakukuha siya sa hangin. So ang isang bumabahing, isang umuubo, maaari siyang makahawa ng mga nasa paligid niya na malapit o kaya nasa kwarto na ang hangin ay sila kanilang hinihinga ng sabay-sabay.
Domingo said, based on the health department's monitoring, although most of the patients are infants and those 5 years old and below, adults can also be susceptible to the disease. Domingo also explained the need for quarantine for those who have close contact with a confirmed pertussis patient.
Ang ating isolation, kasi pag may sakit na, no? Pag ikaw ay nakatagpo ng isang tao na may pertussis at ikaw ay nagsimula na ng gamot, or yung pasyente na may pertussis ay nagsimula ng gamot, pwedeng kahit mga 5 days lang ang iyong isolation. Pero kung hindi pa naggagamot yung pasyente, dapat as long as 21 days. Kasi yung pinaka-infection niya, as long as 21 days. So 5 to 21 days.
The health department admitted that there are regions with low supplies of pertussis vaccine, but the department assured it is ready to bring the supplies to areas where the vaccines are most needed. Johnson Manabat, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Environment Department on alert as the dry season sets in. State Weather Bureau Pagasa on Friday declared the official termination of the northeast monsoon season. The DNR warns of possible bushfires as well as the extension of drought conditions due to warmer temperatures worsened by the El Nino phenomenon. The agency now advising the public, government agencies, and business owners to conserve water to mitigate the impact of the warm and dry season.
Yung forest fires, yan, lagi nating binabantayan yan. And truth be told, hindi tayo kasing handa ng mga ibang bansa patungkol sa patay ng mga forest fires. No? Wala pa tayong ganun kalaking kakayanan. Pangalawa, yung drought conditions dahil dulot ng El Nino ay may maliit na chance na ma-prolong pa ito, no, mag-extend, no, beyond the months that we are thinking that the El Nino will cease. We managed the water level in Angat, no, throughout 2023 at hanggang ngayon, and it's good to tell everybody na medyo puno pa yung dam natin sa kasalukuyan, kaya konting conservation ng gamit ng tubig, and I think itong the next 3 months na tayo'y masusubukan, if we conserve water, wala tayong magiging problema sa ating supply.
The Philippine government vows to identify and address gaps in policies to prevent future cases similar to the controversial Chocolate Hills Resort. In a joint statement released Friday, the Environment, Tourism, and Interior Department said they will start with strengthening regulations, rationalizing land use classification, and enforcing evidence-informed environmental protection standards. They also plan to balance and streamline the representation of bodies governing establishments in protected areas. The viral Captain's Peak resort built at the foot of Chocolate Hills in Bohol drew outrage, prompting its immediate closure. A government task force is looking into possible negligence since the resort obtained a building permit even without the necessary environmental documents. 60,000 individuals joined the Interior Department's Walk Against Drugs this morning. The DALG says the activity aims to show the community support for the holistic fight against illegal drugs. Our correspondent, Job Manahan, is now on the line with the details. What more can you tell us, Job?
Yes, Pia, good afternoon. These 60,000 individuals came from the youth, law enforcement sector, and non-government organizations this Saturday to join the Interior Department in its Lakad Contra Droga, Bida Tayong Lahat, and show the community's commitment against illegal drugs. Pia, the event, which celebrates the first anniversary of the Bida campaign, started in 3 points, the Aliu Theater and Cuneta Astrodome in Pasay and the SMDC Festival Grounds around 4 a.m. Participants then walked and converged at the SM Mall of Asia Arena Concert Grounds for the program proper around 6 a.m. Hazel Mesa with Asangguniang Kabataan Councilor in Barangay 646 San Miguel in Manila said she was very excited to join the activity. Sawit stressed that as an elected SK official, she has the responsibility to spread awareness about combating the use of illegal drugs. In an interview with the media, Interior Secretary Benhur Abalos said the government is trying to win the fight against illegal drugs, but noted that they have to maintain this by identifying which areas need more attention. Data shared by Abalos showed that from November of 2022, or when the Bida campaign was launched, until November 2023, there were 75,831 drug operations, wherein more than 95,000 drug personalities were arrested and around 21 billion worth of illegal drugs were confiscated. The Interior Chief added that 177 police personnel were filed with cases for alleged involvement in illegal drugs as part of their house cleaning. A total of 1,240 anti-drug abuse councils nationwide are functional, and community-based rehabilitations are available in more than 1,500 local government units. Pia, among those who also participate were for Manny Pacquiao, San Juan Mayor Francis Zamora, MMDH Mandomando Artes, and Malambon Mayor Jeannie Sandoval. Zamora said participating in the event was important to show the support on the government's drug fight. San Juan is the only city in Metro Manila, he said, that is drug cleared. The Bida program was launched late November 2022 and aims to clamp down on drug use through communities. The ALG has so far partnered with the PBA, Philippine Volleyball League, and the UAAP to further the cause. ABS-CBN is also one of the ALG's partners for its anti-drug campaign. Pia.
All right, thank you very much for that update, Job Manahan. Philippine authorities looking at several options for the return of expelled lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. Teves was arrested in Timor-Leste Thursday while playing golf. The Justice Department says aside from extradition, Teves could also be deported, which it says is a faster process. The DOJ also vowing it will prioritize the safety of the former congressman.
So if we choose that route, deportation, the timing will be up to them. Pero kung extradition, which will again take some time because of the requirements for extradition, we will have to wait for all of that. Pero magiging obligation na po ng Timor-Leste government na ipadala talaga si Ginong Teves dito.
Teves is facing multiple murder charges linked to killings in Negros Oriental. The most high profile is the March 2023 murder of Negros Oriental Governor Roel Digamo. For the widow of the slain governor, Pamplona Mayor Janice Digamo, the arrest of Teves is an answered prayer.
We have been longing for this for so long. And thank you for being a God of justice. Talagang alam ko na we are praying to a God of justice and that what happened to Ruel is something talaga na dapat may justisya. So it's an answered prayer. Happy kami. We're happy na it's beginning to happen, that justice will be ours. Talagang makukuha natin ito for our loved ones.
As soon as Tevez is back in the country, he will have to be arraigned by the court. He may also be detained in Camp Krame or the National Bureau of Investigation compound due to possible security concerns. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. also lauds the arrest of Tevez. On X, Marcos commended the collaborative efforts of Philippine and international law enforcement agencies. He also assured the public his government will take all necessary actions to bring Tevez back to the country so he can face the charges filed against him. The Tevez family gearing for tough days ahead after the arrest of the former lawmaker. His brother, former Negros Oriental Governor Pride Henry Tevez, said their family is preparing to give their all-out support to his brother. Like Arnolfo Tevez Jr., the younger Tevez has also been tagged by the Philippine government as a terrorist for his alleged involvement in assassinations in Negros Oriental.
He should be very strong at that point. And as family members, we should be all there to take turns supporting him emotionally, spiritually, and mentally. Because it's no joke. You know? It will really be a completely different way of living. Detention is one thing. Loss of communication is another. Right from the start, when this issue happened, like, it already affected us a lot. When you were designated, you lose your bank accounts, then you lose access to your credit lines. Yet, you still have to continue to live because you have bills to pay. Ang mangyayari is you do alternative finding ways of how to make money. Lucky for me, I'm a farmer, so I concentrated on that.
A Philippine resupply mission in the West Philippine Sea endures another harassment by the Chinese Coast Guard. Two of Beijing's vessels blasted water cannons at a Philippine supply boat this morning. Our correspondent Andrea Taguines joins us on the line for more. Andrea, what can you tell us?
Hi, Pia. A Philippine supply boat sustained heavy damage after it was fired at with water cannons by two Chinese Coast Guard ships in Ayungan Shoal Saturday morning. That's according to the Armed Forces of the Philippines. In a video released by the AFP, the two Chinese vessels can be seen ganging up on the Oniza May 4, that's the Philippine supply boat, from opposite directions. According to the AFP, the Chinese Coast Guard started the water cannon attacks at around 7:59 this morning, first with just one vessel going after the Oniza May 4, and then another joined in at around 8:38 a.m., By 8:52 a.m., the AFP said the Philippine supply boat had already been heavily damaged amid the continuous harassment. The Oniza May 4 was headed to the BRP Sierra Madre to deliver fresh supplies to Philippine troops stationed at Ayungan Shoal in the West Philippine Sea. Earlier during the day, at 6:08 a.m., the AFP said a Chinese Coast Guard vessel also performed a dangerous maneuver of crossing the bow against the Oniza May 4. Then at around 7, the same vessel did a reverse blocking maneuver, which caused a near collision. The AFP also supplied videos of these incidents. The resupply boat was initially escorted by the Philippine Coast Guard vessel BRP Cabra, but according to PCG spokesperson for the West Philippine Sea, Commodore J. Targuela, it was separated from the resupply boat after a Chinese Coast Guard vessel and two other Chinese maritime militia vessels encircled the PCG ship. In a statement posted on X, Targuela slammed Chinese maritime forces for their, what he described as their irresponsible and provocative behavior, adding that they have shown a disregard for the Convention on the International Regulations for Preventing Collisions at Sea. So far, the latest update we have is that at around 9:53 a.m., the AFP said the PCG's BRP Cabra has managed to reach the Oniza May 4 to provide assistance to the supply boat, which had been significantly damaged. ABS-CBN News has also reached out to the AFP and the PCG for more updates on the fate of the resupply mission, if it will still push through, or if whether any personnel was injured by the incident, but they have yet to get back to us. China in the past had also blocked and fired water cannons at similar Philippine resupply missions. This maritime conflict between China and the Philippines has gone on for years, with Beijing refusing to recognize a 2016 arbitral ruling, which invalidated China's claim that practically all of South China Sea, including the West Philippine Sea, is theirs. Yeah.
All right. Thank you for that update, Andrea Taguines. Heads up, motorists, brace for a hefty price hike for some petroleum products ahead of the Holy Week break. Alvin El Chico tells us more.
After three consecutive rollbacks, a big-time oil price hike looms next week for gasoline, diesel, and kerosene. Based on the first four trading days in the world market, imported gasoline is up by more than 2 pesos per liter, while diesel and kerosene prices rose by more than 1 peso per liter. The Energy Department explains Ukraine's attack on oil refineries in Russia, lower imports from Iraq, and reduced oil inventory in the U.S. pushed prices up.
Any reason for disruption ng supply, makaka-apekto po, di po ba? Kahit sabihin mo na hindi tayo dun kumukuha, kung lahat naman dun kumukuha, tas kulang na nga yung supply, talagang tataas po yung presyo.
Independent player Jetty Petroleum said the increase in gasoline prices next week will definitely be more than 2 pesos per liter.
Ang tingin natin sa diesel, mag-i-end po for the week would be nasa mga 125 to 145 po yung increase. No? Increase pa rin po, pero nabawasan po. Ano? Ang gasolina na medyo nakitaan din po natin ang pwedeng magbawasan. Ano? So pwede pong bumaba yan ng mga 215 to 235.
Meanwhile, the Energy Department is set to issue an order mandating the increase in biodiesel content on diesel from the current 2% to 3%.
Effective yan, October 1. Year. And then succeeding years, mga tatlo yan eh, B3, B4, and B5. So 3%, 4%, 5% sa 2025 and 2026.
Higher ethanol on gasoline will be implemented on a voluntary basis from the current 10% to 20% or E20 this year. Some independent oil firms are studying their options on E20.
Medyo hindi pa ganun ka positive yung reaction or reception ng motorists, particularly ng mga motorcycles, which is medyo lumalaki yung volume natin doon. Hindi pa ganun ka positive doon sa higher blend.
The DOE is advising motorists, including motorcycle riders, to read the manual if their vehicles can take E20 gasoline. The agency earlier said increasing the ethanol blend could cut gasoline prices by as much as 1 peso per liter. Alvin El Chico, ABS-CBN News.